Hey, good afternoon. Mark's Conte, former sanitation enforcement agent for the city of New York. Enjoying another day of white privilege. White privilege. I'm so privileged. I feel so privileged. I feel so privileged to be white. Okay. So privileged. Okay, so I want to continue with a very uncomfortable topic. Very uncomfortable. Is the issue of... Let me fix my hair. Very, very difficult subject to talk about in New York City is the issue of race, right? Now, again, this is Conte versus DSNY. There is a reason why I'm doing these videos, is that I'm, I am a white male, over 50, drug and alcohol history stuff, right? And was aggressively discriminated against in the workplace. So I filed suit and... In that process, I also discovered an illicit ticket quota that the city of New York uses against its own people. And so anyway, but I want to reflect on something that is, just fucked up. Right? So here, I went down, if you watched a video or two ago, I went down to the New York City Human Rights Commission, right, at 22 Reed Street at Elk in downtown New York City. And it's in the area of the courts, 60 Center Street, the FBI building is across the street. And so all this stuff is going on down there, and there's this unmarked building, right? Now, I know what it is. I know it's the New York City Human Rights Commission. I know that because I sent mail there, and I sent some email, and I had some correspondence. But my case ultimately was heard at New York State Division of Human Rights. So giving them the benefit of doubt, I really didn't know too much about what it was. So, but I did look into it, right? Okay, I did look into it. So what I did was I took a look and I found out. I said, okay, well, what's going on down there? What is it? You know, it's the New York City Commission of Human Rights. And I went in there and I tried to figure out, okay, so who's in charge? Who's in charge down there? This is, okay, so let's call some stuff here, right? Call some faces. So this is the lovely commissioner, and her name is Carmelyn P. Horrible with names. Carmelyn P. Malalis. Carmen P. Malalis, okay? She's the one on the right, okay? She's the one that's slightly taller with the brown jacket and the red purse. And to her right is her lovely wife. Black African-American woman of color. Okay. Hey, I look happy. Look, he smiles. I got rings. Happy people, right? No, I don't give a shit. Yeah, don't take, you know, whatever floats your boat, you know? Right. So here they go. So this is the commissioner and this is her lovely bride. So I went to the site, I went to their YouTube channel, I was like, okay, they had a bunch of commercials up on discrimination and retaliation and all this shit, right? So I said, okay, well, anything that interests me, you know, what about it? And I found this very, very cool video on the practice of discrimination in employment. I said, oh, that's right up my alley. It's like... That's me. That happened to me, right? That's what happened to me. So here's a commercial for me. Well, let's see what happens in the commercial. Let's see if it's anything that's, pertainable. Let's watch the video. Let's just watch it.
Yeah, sorry I had to rush the interview. I got to go meet somebody for lunch.
No problem. Well, like I said, I have years of restaurant experience. I'll make a great maitre d'. I'll take care of your customers.
Sure. We'll talk soon.
Great.
Yeah, why would you send me a candidate like that? You know Tyrone wouldn't be a good fit for the restaurant.
Ooh, that was harsh. That was harsh. Tyrone got thrown under the bus. I fell for him. I fell for Tyrone. Tyrone said he's got years of restaurant experience. He's in a restaurant. It looks like he's downtown Manhattan somewhere. Tyrone was the man. He was the maitre d' for the job. And that white man dissed him. White man dissed him. White man said, You know what? Why are you sending me Tyrone? I want Mario. You sent me Tyrone. I wanted Mario. I'm trying to be lighthearted about it, right? But this is not just any commercial. This is a commercial on the New York City Commission of Human Rights, and they're obviously Tyrone and the short white guy are actors, and they're not. This is not real life. But why do you have to? Why is the white man discriminating against the black man? Why is it? Is that always the way it is? Is that just the way it is? Right? It never happens the other way. Well, I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. So let's look at another one. I found another commercial. I said, oh shit, this is another one. This one said about faith. Oh, you have a right to practice your faith in America. Faith. I like faith. You know, my grandparents were from Italy. They were Italians. They loved the cross and Jesus. And I became a Buddhist. I sat in meditation for you know, silence for a lot. So that's my faith, right? My faith. I'm also vegan, vegetarian. So, well, let's watch the commercial, see what happens. This is awesome. This is awesome, right? Let's watch the commercial.
Masha, we should be contaminated, inshallah. I love you, baby.
Excuse me, sir.
Hi, is the dentist ready to see me?
No, not yet. I was coming over to ask if you could stop speaking that Muslim language. You're really scaring our other patients.
Oh, that was such a slap in the face. I love you, baby. He said, I love you, baby, on the phone. I said, I love you, baby. I love you, baby. And that big, fat white woman came over and said, can you stop speaking that Muslim language? You're scaring my people away. What is going on here? What's going on? That is a harsh thing to say to someone. It's totally, totally unacceptable. Right? Guy should be able. Guy's using his phone, coming in a dentist's office in his neighborhood, trying to get his teeth cleaned, doing the right thing. Nice guy, telling his baby he loves him on the phone, and some woman comes over and tells him stop speaking that Muslim language because you're scaring my people. You're scaring my people. You're scaring other people trying to get their teeth cleaned. Right? So, look. You could have picked anybody, but why did you pick? Why is the woman is obviously white, right? You can hear it in her accent. She is a white woman, probably in the suburbs somewhere, right? And it's the white person discriminating against the Muslim, the Arab guy, right? Now, what, again, you could have picked any actors, but you specifically picked the white person to do the discriminating because it doesn't happen any other way, all right? According to New York City Human Rights Commission, right? There's only one way to discriminate, and that's white people, right? They're the base, right? And all discrimination stems from the white people, right? The whites, they're the ones causing all the problems, right? So, well, again, maybe it's, I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Maybe that's just, I don't know. I'm going down the list. I'm trying to check out all their commercials, see if they're, you know, valid. You know, well, let's look at another one. Let's try one more and see what happens. Well, we're gonna give them the benefit of the doubt. We're gonna give you guys the benefit of the doubt, right? Let's try.
Welcome to the community theater, folks.
Vamos a sentarnos, mi amor.
Sientes emoción?
Come on, people. Speak English. This is America. Island, folks.
Oh, that was that one. Oh, that hurt. Oh, that young girl. she got dissed. She got dissed. She was speaking. She was just speaking Spanish in the city that she loves, and that white man said, "Come on, folks. Come on, folks. Come on, this is America. Come on, folks, this is America." But again, why is it a white guy? Why is it in again the third time? Three in a row. Three in a row. I'm trying to make fun of this because, you know what? I'm trying to make fun with this because if I don't make fun with this and I don't point this stuff out, I'm going to go crazy, right? I'm already crazy, but I'm going to go even more crazy because it's so obvious. It's so obvious. Again, folks, this is not some TV commercial, right? This is not some propaganda trying to sell you something. This is the New York City Commission on Human Rights. This is signed and sealed with taxpayer money, right? And this is the message you're sending out. And you say, well, why is there discrimination in the city against white people? These folks, if you ask them, they probably say, well, there is no discrimination against white people. They're the base. They're the discriminators, right? Isn't that always the way it is? But when, you know, when you see the Hispanic community fighting amongst each other and you have Dominicans fighting Puerto Ricans and they're all fighting over stuff that we don't even know what they're talking about. They're doing it in Spanish. If you understand Spanish, you understand. But the differences are so different. And then so the Dominicans are fighting the Puerto Ricans, and then they're all fighting the Mexicans, you know. And then there's the Cubans and the, you know, all the brands of Hispanic all over the city. And then, you know, there's the Hasidic community out in Borough Park, and there's the Italians out in Howard Beach and they up in the Bronx, and there's all these groups within the city. But why when it comes to discrimination why is it always the white guy attacking the blacks and the Hispanics? Because, and I'm telling you, in my experience, what happens is I walk into the workplace, and this is how you're programming our city. This is your fault. This is discrimination. This is discrimination. It's not once. It's not twice. It's three in a row. It's on your site. It's on your YouTube site. Right? I'm using it. That's just the way it goes. But, you know, whatever. You make up your own mind, folks. But I just showed you that's the, you know, Commission of Human Rights. Change your ways, man. Open up. Open up. Listen to what I'm saying. I can't even get in the door because I'm white. Maybe I should, you know, what I gotta do? You know, what do I have to do? I'm the villain. Okay, you have it your way, guys.